Hallo zusammen. Since season 3, 3 of Düster, Dark, the first German Netflix production is quite rapidly approaching at this point, and you guys seem to like that German production, that German show, and you might also be interested in learning some German along the way if you're watching my channel, I thought, you know what? I like the show, you like the show, I like German, you like German. Let's combine all these things. Why not? And that's why today we're gonna learn and find out about some German terms that are related to the show, the characters, the plot, what's happening there, and pretty much for each letter in the alphabet. And of course, since all these terms are somewhat related to Dark and what's happening in the show, they are somewhat like spoilers here and there, maybe. So if you haven't watched the first two seasons yet, be prepared for some minor, major spoilers. Alright, so let's begin with the first letter in the German alphabet, which is A. A. Das Atomkraftwerk, Singular. Die Atomkraftwerke, Plural. Or das AKW, the main location in the show. The abbreviation AKW is very typical and even gets used in certain standard German contexts, for instance in news shows. B. B. Der Bunker, Singular, die Bunker, Plural. Another mysterious spot which more or less connects many people and things here. It's mostly the context that reveals if it's one or multiple Bunker, since the actual standard form of the noun is the same in nominative and accusative, singular and plural. C. C. Die Chefin, Singular. Die Chefinnen, Plural, the female boss. A rather colloquial term referring to feminine bosses, which wouldn't get used in a formal context. It's very common in daily German though. D. D. Düster or dunkel. Both adjectives are pretty similar and both could be translated to dark. Quite ironic that a German show carries an English title, haha, isn't it? Die Dunkelheit, Singular. Die Dunkelheiten, Plural. This noun can also be translated to the related noun dark or darkness. There's another possible term, die Düsterkeit, but it doesn't get used nearly as often as Dunkelheit anymore, I'd say. E. E. Das Endlager, Singular. Die Endlager, Plural. The English final or terminal storage for nuclear waste comes so close that it's even a literal equivalent of this German compound word. Die Entführung, Singular. Die Entführungen, Plural. A sort of recurring phenomenon in past, present and future. A kidnapping. And in this case, it's literally a kid that gets napped. Taken away. Or should I rather say it lures itself away because of curiosity? What might be inside a mysterious cave? I don't know. Der Entführer, Singular. Die Entführer, Plural. Obviously, a kidnapping doesn't happen without a kidnapper. Technically, as it's the case for many describing nouns in German, there would also be a feminine form for a female kidnapper. Die Entführerin, Singular. Die Entführerinnen, Plural. F. F. Die Familie, Singular. Die Familien, Plural. Practically, there are four big important ones in the show. And even though many relationships and times are intertwined, there's a red thread that carries through all of them in a way, which is pretty much also family. One part of it is missing, the other part is missing. Them. Die Folter, Singular. Die Foltern, Plural. Experiencing torture is something no one should go through, especially not while being forced to listen to happy 80s synth pop like Nena. A great contrast in the show though. Really, really cool scene. G. G. Das Geheimnis, Singular. Die Geheimnisse, Plural. Another big factor in everything that happens in and around Winden. Secrets. Who knows what? When? And who pretends to know less than they actually do? And what is the reason and source for secrets here and there in the first place? In other words, what is going on? Many of these things that happen there are just geheimnisvoll. A related adjective which I personally really like linguistically speaking, since it translates to secretful, full of secrets. Something is so strange and ungraspable, so to speak, that the amount of mystery is quite high, which makes it even more fascinating. But also maybe dangerous. And of course, die Gegenwart. One of three points in time, which at the same time is also a process, not a steady point in time. To me, that's the mystery and uniqueness of time in a nutshell. H. Die Höhle, singular. Die Höhlen, plural. A quite usual, yet very tempting and fascinating location in the show, which also works as a gateway to different times, people and more. It's especially cute when a little white doggy comes running out of it. Das Hotel, singular. Die Hotels, plural. Even though this location hasn't gotten too much screen time yet, it still works as an important building or area, and especially as a connecting place of sorts. For instance, when Ulrich hunts down young Helge Doppler, or for instance when middle-aged Jonas returns to the past and uses his hotel room for combining facts and thoughts. Das Interesse, singular. Die Interessen, plural. Many different people involved in the story have many different interests and plans, and they are not liked by all people involved. J. Der Junge, singular. Die Jungen, plural. Innocent, yet endangered, when there's Ulrich in the past and he knows what you're gonna do and turn to in, well, the future, which is actually the present time. Der Jugendliche, singular, die Jugendlichen, plural. Basically a very important and connecting group in Winden, since as friends, or, well, at some point even foes for that matter, they gradually find out more about what's happening. K. Kurios. Probably a good, neat adjective to describe what's going on, yet it doesn't express the level of strangeness that's going on totally. L. Die List, singular, die Listen. Plural. Not to be confused with die Liste, which is the list in English. But the German list doesn't equal the English list. It rather refers to how Adam and Noah try to convince people of their ideologies and their seeming destiny. M&M's. Mysterieux. This refers to one of the strongest qualities of the show, at least in my book. The dense atmosphere and intense mood. Merkwürdig. What I especially like about this term is how it usually means something rather negative, strange, meaning separated from the norm, yet literally speaking it could mean something like worth remembering, which rather could be understood as something neutral or even positive. N. Quite the same. Die Normalität. And to get a bit philosophical at this point, it exists yet it doesn't, depending on which level you're looking at or living in. Talking from the character's perspective here. I mean, what is normality anyway? Does it exist objectively? Or is it an empty concept which every one of us fills with their own morals and experiences and thoughts and opinions and wishes? I don't know. What do you think? Nebulös. One of my favorite German adjectives for describing a mysterious atmosphere which you can't really judge completely, or like a situation you can't really grasp and you don't really know every single detail to it to really objectively being able to evaluate it. I wonder if the equivalent English term nebulous is directly derived from this German adjective, which is related to the German noun der Nebel, the mist or fog. Das Opfer, singular, die Opfer, plural. And again, it's the context that tells us if it's one or multiple victims. P. Der Preis. Maybe the most surprising choice on this list, but I'm not talking about a price for something you can buy at a store, for instance. It's rather a price that you have to pay in order to make things right. A good example could be older Jonas, middle-aged Jonas, who needs to come back and warn his younger self about what's gonna happen. Or potentially gonna happen. Q. Die Quelle, singular.
Die Quellen, plural, another ambiguous term which can refer to something physical, objects like the cave, or to something cognitive and mental. The source of making decisions might be knowledge, for instance. Die Qual, singular. Die Qualen, plural, closely related to the aforementioned Folter, yet it could also be related to an inner struggle, something that's bothering you so much that you are basically suffering from something you can't change, at least not in this time zone.
Er.
Der Rebell, singular, die Rebellen, plural, a group of people we get to know in the quite dystopian future when things seem to be irretrievably lost. Die Rückkehr. I always wonder if middle-aged Jonas hadn't come back, would anything have happened differently or at all at a later date like that?
S. I think it's good that there is a little pause in between those two.
Die Suche, singular. Die Suchen, plural. The search for answers, gateways, people. Some things get found while others don't, and sometimes you even talk to someone you think you don't know, yet you do.
T.
Die Trauer, one of the first emotions we're faced with in the show, maybe indirectly so, but it's still there, and one that basically runs underneath everything that's happening. I for one was pretty sad when old Egon Tiedemann fell in the kitchen, for instance. It's a strong emotion in Dark since it breaks the fourth wall in a way, and also affects the viewer, not only the characters in the show. And that, I think, is a true sign of a great show. Der Täter, singular. Die Täter, plural. There are more of them than meets the eye, and even though they act the way they do, you rarely get to know why exactly they do certain things a certain way, at least not right away. Noah is a very good example, I think.
You.
Unglaublich. Unglaubwürdig. Unvorhersehbar. Undurchschaubar. Four adjectives which are somewhat related and similar in their structure, and again all four can be linked to things happening in Dark, but also to what viewers might experience while watching the show.
V. Wie?
Die Vorgesetzte, singular. Die Vorgesetzten, plural. As I've hinted before, this is the standard and formal term for a female superior or supervisor or even your female boss. Verschwunden, vermisst. Verschollen. Again, three closely related adjectives. They don't necessarily all have to apply to the same situation every time, but in terms of Mikkel Nielsen, for instance, all of them are true and sort of apply in a way. Die Vergangenheit. Another tense and period in time, which can also be a point in time, I guess, depending on what you want to express with it. Usually you can't change it, but in Dark you might be able to.
V. W.
Winden. You might be asking yourself, okay, why the town's name? Well, because it also exists as a verb in German, which is a self-reflexive term in this case, meaning to wind and turn oneself. Also in a way, I guess, to hesitate, you could say. I think that's true for Jonas, among others, since he doesn't want to follow Adam's prophecies at first. Or maybe at all.
X.
Die Xenophobie. Doesn't fit too well. Yeah, I admit that. Because no one is playing a xylophone, for instance. I think the fear and negative point of view towards strangers somewhat expresses the helplessness some characters go through and experience when they first meet middle-aged Jonas, who has traveled back into the present.
Y. Why? Yes, I admit I couldn't come up with a better term. As long as no one is really, like really, really thoroughly enjoying eating yogurt. Back in the day, in German, you could also spell it with a Y, whereas nowadays you would spell it with a J, Joghurt. But haha, smart of me to mention this now. Well, I've also made another video about Dark and typical German things in the show, so if you want to check that out, feel free to do that, and you can find it linked in the end card to this video. Z, Z, or Z.
Die Zeitreise, singular. Die Zeitreisen, plural. Nothing would be the same, let alone happen like this, without this storytelling element. I've always been fascinated by this concept. The same is true for die Zeitmaschine, singular, die Zeitmaschinen, plural. Some cool machines they got there in dark, I have to say. Die Zukunft, the literally last and the only time zone without a proper ending to it. In terms of Winden, the future might be really, really, really dark for almost all citizens if things don't get changed. In time. And because you have sticked around to the end, here are a few bonuses. The three Umlaute, ö, and ü. Because yes, we also have German terms that start with these letters. For instance, das Äquivalent could refer to many festations of one and the same person. For instance, young and middle-aged Jonas and Adam. Die Öffentlichkeit, the biggest yet most undefined group which knows the least about what is going on and what is possible, I guess. And lastly, die Überraschung, singular, die Überraschungen, plural, a similar term to those that I mentioned for you, even though these can be a bit more positive yet also negatively connotated. Let's hope dark will remain a pleasant, sad, funny, happy surprise for all of us in season 3. Of course, I would also like to know if you know more German words that could also relate and refer to the show and what's happening there. Feel free to tell me in the comments down below. And to say it in German, lasst uns die Daumen drücken, let's keep our thumbs pressed that the new season will be as awesome as the first two. I hope that will be the case, because it's also going to be the last, and I hope there's going to be a really epic finale. So, yeah. Let's wait and see, I guess. Thanks for watching, everyone. I'm your Vlog Dave. Tschüss und bis zum nächsten Mal.